Welcome guys, welcome to our channel. So today in this video I'm going to share you one of the interview questions that I have encountered in my recent interviews. So this question was like, basically the question was, the question is very simple, but I was unable to give a solution using Java if strings. So the question was this. So I was given an array of integers. I was asked to print key value pairs, like how many times a number is getting repeated. So 2 is getting repeated one time, it is like it is only one time, 3 is being repeated 2 times, 4 is getting repeated 2 times. So this question was asked to me in one of the company called Ivy Comtech. In that interview I was asked this question and I was unable to give the solution using string. So then later on I thought this is a very what I can say, very below average question, so I won't be getting this kind of questions in my any other of interview. But believe me, after 4 to 5 days in Tech Mahindra interview, the same question was asked. Instead of integers, it was strings, and again I was unable to give the answer. So usually whenever I am unable to give any coding answer, I usually go back home and prepare for the coding question, like why I was unable to give the solution. But when when I was unable to give the answer for the first whenever I was unable to give the answer for the first question, still I didn't practice, because thinking nobody will be asking this kind of questions. But like what I can say, unexpectedly, hard luck. So I have encountered the same question again within few days. The same question again appeared in front of me, and in both the interviews I was unable to give the solution because I was not able to find out. Like I haven't practiced it. To be honest, you need to know some internal classes of Java 8 to give a solution for this solution. So let us see how. Later on I practice, and let us see. The reason for sharing this question is, maybe I feel there might be at least one or two guys who, like me, like who might be not aware of these classes. So I am sharing this for them. So let us give the solution. Number list dot string dot collectors dot grouping by. So to be honest, I know how to use grouping by function, but here the trick was I was not knowing this thing, function dot identity should be the key, comma, okay, let me break it from here, grouping by function dot identity, common collectors dot counting. So this was the solution that we were expecting from me. To be honest, I know every part of this, but I wasn't aware of this function dot identity. So I was unable to get the answer at that time. So let us capture this output that is called map of string and integer and long, and let us print this output now. So dot for each, and key value pairs will be there, key value lambda. Let us print this directly. So we throw this out, key plus hyphen plus value. So let us print this and see whether we are getting our desired output or not. So yes, we are getting the desired output. 3 got repeated twice, 4 got repeated twice, 9 got repeated twice. And let us see, the similar solution was for array list as well. Okay, let's see that solution as well. Dot stream dot. So basically the intention is, don't underestimate any question thinking you are experience is high, you will not be getting this kind of questions. Anyone can get any question. So this was the only 2 questions in those interviews I was unable to give answers. So don't do this mistake. I'll not do this mistake again, to be honest. Like once a mistake, then okay, fine, but again and again repeating the same mistake is wrong. So I'll not do that. I'll prepare you no matter how small the question is. We should respect that question. I thought it came to take revenge from me after not preparing, even though it was asked to me in earlier interview or put to. So create a local variable. Yep, and let me copy paste this file to print. Let us run this application now. Okay, and see, yeah, we got our desired outputs, and I was, and if at all, that's how we can give the solution. So basically, this was the key here, like function identity, that I was not aware of, like what actually it does. So later on, I learned it, and I have started applying it, like coding, doing some practices. So if at all someone wants the solution in the traditional way, here it is. So here is the solution. I was having this already, so I just copy pasted. So I have created a map to store the output using enhanced for loop. I was iterating in the string list, so I was checking the map whether if it is containing the key. If it is containing the key, then I was getting the value, I was incrementing the value, and again I was keeping putting that back into the map, or else I was putting the I was inserting it as a new entry, and I was this is how I was oh sorry this is how I was welcome okay oh this is how I was printing it. Let us run this and see. We can say legacy, now it has become legacy to enhance for loop. So yeah, this is four times we got the same output, but this was not the expected, at least with the experience that I carry. He was expecting me to know each and every class in Java 8, but sadly I was not sure of these classes. So that's it in this video. If all you guys have not yet subscribed, please do subscribe by hitting the subscribe button. And if all you want to contribute us, you can open any one of our interview or any of your videos. And on your next shopping at Amazon, you can use our Amazon affiliation link. And when you click it, it will take you to Amazon app or Amazon website. Here you can search your item, whatever item you want, like if at all I want GoPro coming. Okay, so I'll go all, so basically anything you can go and buy. Before buying that, please use our affiliation link, so that we might get some commission out of it. That's it, that is what I wanted to show here. If you haven't subscribed, please do subscribe. There are many videos that are queued up, and thanks for watching. Bye bye.